Today I will explain how to type traditional Chinese using the Chongqi input method, which is an input method that's most commonly used in Hong Kong and Macau. To type a character using Chongqi, we decompose it into smaller shapes which can be represented by radicals. There are 24 radicals, and they each correspond to a letter on the keyboard. So, tin, sui, hou, ya, bo, san, guo, yun, sum, yet, si, mo, fo, to, jo, sum, dai, zhong, gum, nu, yu, gong, yet. We can ignore Z and X for now. They have special purposes that will be explained in a later video. I suggest printing out this keyboard chart and keeping it somewhere where you can easily refer to it. Each of the radicals is also a character in and of itself. For example, if you want to type su, you would simply type J. If you wanted to type no, you would type V. With this in mind, you already know how to type 24 Chinese characters. We can also start typing some basic combinations. The character Ming is a classic example. You can decompose this by noticing that the left side is the character Ya, and the right side is the character Yu. So to type Ming, we would type A, then B. Next, the character Tin. This starts off with one horizontal line. Ya. Underneath it is the character Dai. So to type Tin, we would type MK. Next, Che. This starts off with a sup at the top. Tin in the middle. And another sup at the bottom. So to type te, we will type J, W, then J.
If you know how to write Chinese, you might find this a bit strange, but Chongqi doesn't care about stroke order. As long as a decomposition follows its rules, then that will be the code that is used. As you can see from these examples, characters are usually decomposed from left to right and top to bottom. Another rule is that characters are generally decomposed outside to inside, and we will come across examples in later videos. I'll end this off by leaving you with some practice examples. Try to figure out the Chongqi codes for the following characters. Yu, bun, sui, sam, chut, zhong, si, dan, lei. You can check the solutions in the description of this video. In the next video, I will discuss auxiliary characters. If you have any questions, feel free to leave a comment. Thanks for watching.